So we are given number of possible isomers for the complex CO, EN2, CL2, Cl will be. Now the complex given to us is this one, this is CO, EN2, Cl2 and Cl. Now we know that this particular complex can be arranged in two different ways, like this one and the other is this. Now in this I have arranged Cl and Cl in the translocations, so the En and En will be trans to each other as well, while in the other one here the Cl and Cl are cis and so is En and En. So we have two possible arrangements, one is a trans arrangement and the other is the cis arrangement. Now in this trans arrangement, as you can see that there is a plane of symmetry and which can divide the molecule into two identical halves, and that's why this molecule will be optically inactive and no further isomerism is possible with this compound. So this will be only one of its type, that is the trans will be only one. Now coming on to this, does not have any plane of symmetry, whether you take the horizontal plane or the vertical plane, the molecule will not be cut into two identical halves, and that's why this molecule will show optical activity. This indicates that its mirror image will be an enantiomer of this compound, and that's why the cis will have two compounds, cis dextro and cis levo. So it will have two isomers and one isomer with this. So when we say that this is one isomer for the trans and two isomer for the cis, will make three isomer in total. So there will be three total isomers possible for this compound. Question number 38. The variation of the boiling points of hydrogen halide is in the order HF, HI, HBr and HCl. Now it is already given that the answer will be HF more than, it is HI more than, HBr more than HCl. Now we are asked the reason for this, that what is the most suitable reason for this. As we know that in the halides HF, HCl, HBr and HI, their molecular weight is increasing. With the increase in molecular weight, the boiling point also increase. But in HF there is H bonding, so the H bonding will play the dominating role over here, and this will outweigh the effect of the molecular weight in the other compounds. That's why the HF will show the highest boiling point in this sequence, and the others, since they do not have any H bonding, that's why their answer will come from molecular weight. This indicates that the order of H bonding or the order of this boiling point will be this due to the H bonding effect in HF. So let us see the options now. The first option says that the bond energy of HF molecule is greater than in the other hydrogen halides. Now the bond energy of this molecule is of course more, but then it is not the factor which influences the boiling point, and that's why this is not the correct option. Second is the effect of nuclear shielding is much reduced in fluorine which polarize the HF molecule. Now this effect is also not related to the boiling point. The third is electronegativity of fluorine is much higher than for the other elements in the group. Now the electronegativity of F is very high, but that again is not the direct reason, because when you say a high electronegativity, it directly does not mean that the boiling point will be high. So it means the H bonding should be the criterion. Let us see the fourth option now. There is a strong H bonding between HF molecules, which is the correct option.
Question number 39. In this question, first of all, we will write down the reaction. Silver nitrate plus NaCl, it gives AgCl and NaNO3. In this reaction, first of all, we will find out the moles of silver nitrate and NaCl. अगर आप क्वेश्चन को ध्यान से पढ़ें तो दोनों इस क्वेश्चन के अंदर दोनों मिक्सचर्स के 16.9% W by V और 5.8% W by V सॉल्यूशंस लिए गए हैं. इसका मतलब 100 ml सॉल्यूशन के अंदर सिल्वर नाइट्रेट के 16.9 ग्राम प्रेजेंट है. अगर इसके मोल फाइंड आउट किए जाए, डिवाइडेड बाय इट्स मॉलिक्यूलर मास, 16.9 डिवाइड बाय 169.8, दीज आर द मोल्स ऑफ सिल्वर नाइट्रेट प्रेजेंट इन 100 ml ऑफ सॉल्यूशन. लेकिन सॉल्यूशन में सिर्फ इसके 50 ml ही लिए गए हैं, इसलिए डिवाइड बाय 2 करने से 50 ml के अंदर प्रेजेंट मोल्स निकाले जा सकते हैं. सिमिलरली NaCl के भी 50 ml के अंदर प्रेजेंट मोल्स इतने आ जाएंगे। अगर इन दोनों मोल्स को सॉल्व किया जाए तो पहला आंसर 0.049 और दूसरा आंसर भी 0.049 आ रहा है। इसका मतलब इन दोनों में कोई भी लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट नहीं है, दोनों एक साथ खत्म हो जाएंगे। जब दोनों एक साथ खत्म हो जाएंगे तो फाइनली हमें AgCl के 0.049 मोल्स अचीव हो जाएंगे। अगर AgCl का मास निकाला जाए 0.049 इनटू इट्स मॉलिक्यूलर मास, सॉल्व करने पे 7.0217 ग्राम, अप्रोक्सीमेटली 7 ग्राम AgCl फॉर्म हो जाएगा। हमसे ये पूछा गया है क्वेश्चन के अंदर कि कितने ग्राम प्रेसिपिटेशन होगा, आंसर विल बी 7 ग्राम प्रेसिपिटेशन, सो दैट द आंसर विल बी ए पार्ट।